Hello, Vital Sine. Today we're going to cover two important properties of the conormal product of graphs. To recap, the conormal product of two graphs G and H is itself a graph with a vertex set equal to the Cartesian product of the vertex sets of G and of H. Two vertices are adjacent in the conormal product of G and H if they meet at least one of the following conditions. The first adjacency condition is that their left entries are adjacent in graph G. The second adjacency condition is that their right entries are adjacent in graph H. In other words, if the left entries are adjacent, inclusive or, the right entries are adjacent, then the vertices are adjacent in the conormal product. All right, now let's get to our first property. What is the size, that is, the number of edges, of the conormal product of some two graphs, G and H? Well, here's one approach to solve this problem. Find the number of pairs of conormal product vertices that satisfy the first adjacency condition. Add that to the number of pairs of conormal product vertices that satisfy the second adjacency condition. And then subtract the number of pairs satisfied by both conditions. Let me show you what I mean. The first adjacency condition says that two vertices in the conormal product are adjacent if their left entries are adjacent in the left graph, G. This means that each edge in graph G, which represents a single pair of adjacent vertices in graph G, will produce as many edges in the conormal product as there are ordered pairs of vertices in graph H. For instance, suppose the vertices of graph G are A1, A2, A3, and A4, and the vertices of graph H are B1, B2, and B3. Also suppose that there is an edge in graph G, A1, A2. Then that edge produces all of the following adjacencies in the conormal product. Note how we essentially fixed the left entries to represent a given edge in the left graph G, and then vary the right entries over all possible combinations of two vertices, even including the case where both are the same vertex in the right graph H. If we then repeat this process for every pair of adjacent vertices in graph G, we would capture all of the pairs of conormal product vertices that satisfy the first adjacency condition. The question now becomes, what is the total number of pairs that we get from this process? Well, it will be the number of edges in graph G times the number of possible ordered pairs of vertices from graph H. If we call the number of edges in graph G E of G, and the number of vertices from graph H V of H, then our result is E of G times V of H squared. V of H squared comes from the fact that we were varying the right entries of our conormal product vertices over all possible ordered pairs of vertices in graph H. And the number of ordered pairs from a set of V of H distinct elements is V of H squared, visualized as the number of cells in a table, where each row and column in this case represents a vertex in the right graph H. We have now accomplished the first part of our plan. We have the number of pairs of vertices that satisfy the first adjacency rule. We can apply the same method to accomplish the second part of our plan, which is to find the number of pairs that satisfy the second adjacency condition. This time, we would fix the right entries to be an adjacent pair of vertices in graph H, vary the left entries over all possible ordered pairs of vertices in graph G, and then repeat for all unordered adjacent pairs of vertices in graph H, that is, for all edges in graph H. As before, to count these pairs of conormal product vertices that satisfy the second adjacency condition, we need to count the number of edges in the second graph, H, and multiply that by the number of possible ordered pairs of vertices in graph G, giving us E of H times V of G squared. There we go. We've accomplished three steps of our plan now. As the final step, we must subtract the number of pairs of conormal product vertices that satisfied both adjacency conditions, as they are currently being double counted. This is simply the number of pairs of conormal product vertices whose right entries are adjacent in graph H and whose left entries are adjacent in graph G. And what would that number be? Well, for any pair of adjacent vertices, that is for any edge in graph G, we can vary the right entries of those vertices over every possible ordered pair of adjacent vertices in graph H, with each variance generating a new adjacency in the conormal product that satisfies both of our conormal product adjacency conditions. Repeating this process for all pairs of adjacent vertices in G, we get all pairs of adjacent vertices in the product that satisfy both adjacency rules. This means that the number of pairs of vertices in the conormal product that satisfy both adjacency rules equals the product of the number of edges in G with a number of ordered pairs of adjacent vertices in H. The total number of ordered pairs of adjacent vertices in graph H is double the number of edges in graph H. The number of adjacent pairs of vertices in G is just the number of edges in G. Multiplying, we get the total number of adjacent pairs of vertices in the conormal product that satisfy both adjacency conditions. To get our final answer, we just need to subtract this number from our earlier result, giving us this as our final answer for the number of edges in the conormal product of G and H. The final property we examine in this video is a surprising relationship between three graph operations: the complement, strong product, and conormal product of graphs. To recap, the complement of a graph is a graph operation that works like this. If we have a graph G, then in its complement, C of G, every pair of adjacent vertices becomes non-adjacent, and every pair of distinct non-adjacent vertices becomes adjacent. Let's move on to the final property covered in this video. The graph we get by taking the complement of the conormal product of G and H is the very same graph that we would get by taking the strong product of the complement of graph G with the complement of graph H. To see why, let's revisit what the complement operation does to a graph. Essentially, if we have an arbitrary pair of distinct vertices, U and U prime, in some graph G, they are adjacent in the complement of G when they are not adjacent in the original graph. To find the adjacencies of the complement of a conormal product, then, we must find all pairs of distinct, not adjacent vertices in the conormal product. To do that, think about the adjacencies in the conormal product of two graphs, G and H. Specifically, think about the condition for adjacency displayed here. Applying De Morgan's laws to the adjacency rule for conormal products of graphs, we get that two vertices, UV and U' V' in the conormal product, each representing an ordered pair of vertices from graphs G and H, are adjacent as long as it is not the case that both their left and right entries are not adjacent in their respective graphs. That is, the only pairs of non-adjacent conormal product vertices are those where U is not adjacent to U prime and V is not adjacent to V prime. Therefore, the so-called non-adjacency rule for conormal products is the adjacency rule for the complement of a conormal product. But we can dive a bit deeper into this rule, as it actually has three cases. I've placed the adjacency conditions for a conormal product and for the complement of a conormal product at the top for us to use going forward. Moving on to our three cases, the first is this. Suppose we have two conormal product vertices, UV and U' V'. If U equals U' in graph G, that is, they are the same vertex in graph G, and V is not adjacent to V' in graph H, then the two conormal product vertices, UV and U' V', are not adjacent, meaning that the two vertices are adjacent in the complement of the conormal product. The reason V and V' must be distinct in this case is that otherwise UV and U' V' would be the same vertex. Case 2 is this. If U is not adjacent to U' in graph G, and V equals V' in graph H, then UV and U prime V prime are not adjacent, again provided U and U prime are distinct vertices in graph G. This means that UV and U prime V prime are adjacent in the complement of the product. Finally, if U is not adjacent to U prime in graph G, and if V is not adjacent to V prime in graph H, then UV and U prime V prime are not adjacent, meaning that they are adjacent in the complement. Now, compare our three adjacency cases for the complement of a conormal product with the adjacency rules for the strong product. They have a lot in common. The only problem is that we're dealing with a lot of not adjacent to symbols over here, where there are adjacent to symbols on the bottom. But here's what we're going to do. Instead of taking the strong product of G and H and look at the adjacency rules for that product, let's take the strong product of their complements and then look at the adjacency rules for that graph. Now, the adjacency rules still look the same, but this time the left entries are vertices in the complement of G and the right entries are vertices in the complement of H. But remember what taking the complement of a graph does. Any distinct adjacent vertices in the complement correspond to distinct non-adjacent vertices in the original graph. So, coming back to our problem, that means that provided we let our left entries come from the original graph G and our right entries come from the original graph H, and provided these adjacency rules are still for the strong product of the complements, then these adjacency rules transform precisely into those we have above. So now that both the adjacency conditions for the complement of the conormal product and for the strong product of the complements are written in terms of vertices in the original graphs G and H, we can see that they are equivalent. Isn't it amazing that the strong product of the complements is the same as the complement of the conormal product? To finish the video, I'd like to leave you with a few exercises. What is the degree of a vertex in the conormal product of two graphs, expressed in terms of the degrees of its right and left entries? Feel free to post your answer in the comments. If you found the equality between the complement of the conormal product and the strong product of the complements to be interesting, I encourage you to look for other equivalences between products when applying complementation to their factors or to the product itself. There are a lot of neat equivalences out there to be found. In my next video, we'll examine click graphs, a really neat graph operation. Thanks for watching. Please subscribe, like, share, and comment if you liked the video. Have a great day.